Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about RPG applications. Even roleplays that are branded as appless still have some kind of application process. At minimum, you need to give your character's name and something about them, right? So in this video, we're going to discuss how to think about applications, what things you might want to ask on your applications, and also how to accept applications. The point of the application is assessing to the best of your ability if someone is going to fit into the roleplay or not. And depending on the type of roleplay that you're running is going to depend on how simple or complex the application is. But essentially what the application should be doing is answering some fundamental questions that you have about the roleplayer. So here's some examples. Does this person meet our minimum requirements? For example, you might have a minimum requirement of age or technical writing ability. Do they understand the plot and setting of the roleplay? Do they have a character that will be able to integrate into the roleplay that isn't duplicating exactly what someone else is doing? Because if you watch my other videos, you know everyone wants to feel special. Next, let's talk about the meat of the application. What information do you even want to ask for? There are essentially two parts to every RPG application. That's the out-of-character section and the in-character section. So first, let's talk about that out-of-character section. What do you need to know about the MUN that's playing the character? At minimum, I would say you need to know three things. What is their out-of-character name? What is their age? And what are their pronouns? Anything else that you ask in that out-of-character section is going to depend largely on the platform that you're on. But let's break down those three that you're probably going to have on any platform. Why is the name important? It's really difficult to keep MUN and MUSE separated if everyone is just going by their character name. So we want to make sure that the out-of-character name that the person is called is different than their actual character's name to help prevent that character bleed as much as we can. Next, why age? As a mod, part of your responsibility is to ensure that you're running a safe game. And part of making sure that everyone's safe is ensuring that when it comes to not safe for work roleplay, that people are only roleplaying between adults in those situations, that no children are involved. And the only way that you're going to ensure that this happens is by asking for people's age. And lastly, why pronouns? Now, for this question, what you're probably actually asking is why not ask for gender? So there's kind of like two reasons that I recommend to ask for pronouns and not gender. The first reason is that when we're online, we're all essentially strangers, so gender doesn't really matter. And two, the reason is because gender is incredibly complicated, but pronouns aren't. Most people will accept, you know, she, her, he, him, they, them, or some combination of those three. And knowing how to talk about someone in third person is important to facilitate communication, whereas knowing someone's gender identity, it really isn't. So that's the out-of-character section, but what about the in-character section? This is going to vary a lot depending on what type of roleplay you're running, so we're going to focus on some things that are suitable for any type of roleplay. At minimum, you're going to need the same things that you asked for in the out-of-character section. That's name, age, and pronouns, and you want them for the character for the same reasons that you want them for the MUN. But what else? Remember those questions that you asked yourself in the beginning. Now, the way that I get the answers to these questions is with a history and a personality section. Having players describe these two things will help ensure that you're accepting players who understand your plot and setting, and it will also ensure that you're accepting characters that aren't duplicates of other characters that already exist in the roleplay. You might also consider a section on appearance. Now, this section can be describing the character's appearance, it could be a face claim, it could be asking for reference art. Whatever you ask for is fine. It's just to keep it consistent and to help people be able to visualize each other's characters properly. And really, that's all I recommend adding. Everything else that you have on your application is going to be dependent on what type of roleplay you're running. So, for example, if your roleplay involves magic, you need people to describe their character's magic. If it's supernatural, then you need people to pick what creature it is that their character is. If it's a town roleplay, then you're going to need people to say what job they're doing in town. But it's all going to be dependent on the particular type of roleplay you're running as far as adding those things into the application. So if you've done a lot of roleplay applications before, you're probably noticing at this point that something is missing. The writing sample. Why have I removed that? Personally, I don't use writing samples on my applications. This is because someone's writing sample is typically an example of their best writing. And considering roleplay is largely improvisational, does an example of their best writing really matter in this case? I would say no. Besides, also, writing by yourself is fundamentally different than writing a thread with a roleplay partner, so in this way, a writing sample isn't accurate either. And besides, in my case, because I've asked them to write up a history and a personality section, I already know if their writing is base competent. So if you are going to include a writing sample, I recommend asking yourself why you're doing it. So some reasons you might still want to include a writing sample is, say for example, your role play is all pre-made characters with pre-written histories, so you're not asking the players to write a history section for the application. So that means a writing sample might be appropriate to determine if the person can play the character. Another reason that you might want to have a writing sample is if you're running like a really long multi-para like novella style role play, and you need to ensure that people are going to be able to meet your length requirements for their posts. Okay, so now we've thought about what we're looking for in an application, and we've also put one together. Now we know once we open our role play and start advertising it, we're going to start getting applications to our role play. So what do we do with those applications? The first thing I would recommend is do not approve or deny applications by yourself. Make sure there's at least one or two other moderators helping you review applications. And I would say not everyone has to weigh in, but you can't really decide by yourself. And the reason for this is that roleplay is inherently collaborative. So accepting or denying applications should be collaborative as well. Different people are going to raise different points about the app, and if you have multiple opinions, you can really decide if someone's going to fit into your group or not, which is something that's really hard to determine by yourself. The next thing I recommend is having a policy of not denying applications. Now, this doesn't mean you have to accept every application. So if that's the case, how do we do that? How do we make sure that we're not denying applications but still not accepting all of them? So remember those questions that we put together at the beginning that you thought about when you were building your application. Any place where the application doesn't appropriately answer those questions, give the applicant notes. Tell them exactly what isn't working and encourage them to resubmit with those corrections. Now, as I'm having this conversation with a particular applicant, you can usually get a sense if they're really struggling or not to understand what you're talking about. So if they are struggling, what I recommend is for them to go into the general, like, out of character chat and ask others for help on fixing the issues with their application so that they can get lots of different perspectives and lots of different ideas for how to fix it. Keep in mind, the more complex and more lore-heavy your roleplay is, the more people might need to write and rewrite applications until they get one that can be accepted. So what that means is make sure you're not being too strict here. We should be thinking about how the application affects the roleplay as a whole, not your individual preferences and desires. If you use this method, you won't have to deny people. They're going to basically deny themselves with only being willing to do that rewrite so many times. Using this method in the past several years, I can only remember having to deny one application, and that was because they kept resubmitting with the exact same problems that we already talked about. So we eventually did have to issue a denial, but it's super rare. Also, when it comes to this process, it's helpful to be super transparent about it. So make sure that people who are joining and in the application process for your roleplay know that you don't deny apps, but they'll likely get notes about their character that they'll need to fix. This is going to help in twofold. One, it's going to ease their anxiety with filling out the application so they're not scared of getting denied. It's also going to make it so that when you give them those notes, because for most people you probably will, they're not going to have a knee-jerk negative reaction. So is there anything I missed that you guys do in your RPG applications? Do we have things that we have in common that you guys tend to do the same? Let me know in the comments down below. And remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click that bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching and make it a great day.